St Mary's University in Twickenham in southwest London has become the first UK university to offer a pioneering scheme aimed at helping children in care eventually reach university. St Mary's has launched the First Star Academy programme, which started in the US and has already achieved impressive results there. Under the scheme, children aged 14 to 18 in care are offered monthly sessions here on campus, and also the chance to attend residential summer courses. Well, I'm joined here on campus by Ruth Kelly, the Pro Vice Chancellor and former Education Secretary in Tony Blair's government. First of all, can you explain more fully what the scheme is aiming to achieve?
The Pope has told us to go and find those people on the margins of society and to work with them and to educate them. And that's exactly what this programme is about. I mean, we're really aiming to transform the life chances of children in care. They really have terrible outcomes at the moment, largely because they don't have stability even of foster placement. If you're a teenager in care, there's a 50% chance that you'll move placement in any given 12 months. Now, with that sort of disruption to your home life, as well as, of course, to your schooling, it's perhaps not surprising that the outcomes for children in care are really, really terrible. Children who've gone through the care system are at much higher risk of homelessness, of unemployment, of teenage pregnancy. Almost half of them have a diagnosable mental health disorder. So what we're trying to do is work with 14-year-olds all the way through until the age of 18 to really transform their educational experience, to lift their ambitions, and to form a group of children and adults that are part of a strong and bonded community. They spend every summer on campus for 4 weeks, and they get a bespoke educational programme. And we know that by working with them over the summers, as well as one Saturday every month throughout that whole four-year period, we can really change their educational prospects. At the moment, only 6% of young people in care make it to university. That compares with almost 50% of the general population of that age group. Yet we've just run the first summer camp, as it were, for these children, and already they're talking about would they like to go to university, what courses would they be studying, which university would it be. But they'll also be given a programme of practical life skills support, emotional support, and have lots of contact with careers and employment opportunities. So networks that they've never really been able to tap before they'll be exposed to.
Now, you've referred to the seemingly intractable problem of improving the educational outcomes for children in care. Why will this scheme succeed where others have seemingly failed?
Well, we know that it has worked in the United States. We're not starting from scratch. Now, nothing like this has ever been tried in the UK, but in the US, they started this programme in 2011. They've experienced the first two cohorts of children already graduating the programme. Of those children that started, 99% went through high school until the age of 18 and graduated high school at 18, and 90% went on to further a higher education. Now that's way higher than the general population of the same age. So we think we can import what's best in that model and adapt it to the UK situation. And you know, if we have any success that is similar to the success they've achieved in the United States, I think we'll be making a real impact.
Now, when you were Education Secretary, was it a problem that was on your radar back then? And what were you trying to do back then?
Very much so. And I was very much involved in developing a green paper about children in care while I was Education Secretary, which was then published by my successor, Alan Johnson. And one of the things that we really focused on at that time was educational outcomes of children in care. And we set up a system known as virtual head teachers in local authorities. So there is one very senior person in each local authority who has who is responsible for all of the children in care in that borough for their educational progress. Now that's been developed subsequently, and education has been given a real focus and a real priority. But we know there's still so much more to do. There are 6% of young people getting to university now. A decade ago it used to be only 1%, so it has made progress. But we want to get those levels up to the level of, you know, the general population.
So the young people who've been here already at St Mary's over the summer, what have they made of it?
They have thoroughly enjoyed it. I mean, they are really talking already about the difference that it's made. I mean, considering we only hired the director of the academy in the late spring, and he's had very little time to put this programme together, it's really been a remarkable success. So all of the children who started have gone through the four-week programme. Even those who had family holidays booked in the middle have cancelled in order to complete that course. They've all committed to coming back. And we'll hope that we'll see them all the way through the programme and then on to university.
Are you hoping this scheme will be adopted elsewhere in the UK?
Yes, I really do think this could be a model for intervening with children in care. It provides that much, much needed educational stability and stability of community that is all too lacking for so many children in care today. They form a group, they're mentored by university students, and we hope in time to develop a body of students who've been through the care system, who can work with the young people themselves and provide role models for them. We work with the foster families of the children as well. And I do think that this is quite an intensive programme, but one which we are quite confident will be successful.
And finally, why did St Mary's want to assist in solving this problem?
Because we have a mission as a Catholic university to make a difference in the world. And we are very, very determined to make an impact at the local level with our local communities where we can. And when we were approached by the director of First Aura in the United States, Peter Samuelson, about this project, we thought that ties absolutely with our mission as a Catholic university, particularly to work with disadvantaged young people and specifically in the education field. So we thought we had a lot to offer. And I'm absolutely thrilled that we're now able to take this forward.